I'm going to the hospital tomorrow for an MRI. Coming back. So, I'm trying to keep my when I get too emotional, it leeches all my energy, and I can't focus long enough to keep air in my lungs. You wouldn't realize how much energy it takes. I've it's just well, it's not exactly routine, but it's follow up from the because I couldn't make it in the earlier machine, and it takes like a month to set up or to get in there. So hopefully this will be the final MRI. It's just, it's frustrating, I'm sick and tired of being sick and tired, I'm trying to, it's hard to meet people nowadays, especially when you're over your 20s. Because my autism, it's especially, my anxiety activates when trying to talk to people, and imagine trying to meet people going up, you actually get up enough energy, get enough courage to introduce yourself to someone. And you don't know what to say to them. The anxiety, it feels like you're already being judged. Of course, because you are already being judged, you're judging yourself. And And, you know, with all this medical stuff, you know, it's hard to meet people. And in the pandemic, you know, it feels especially hard. Since 2018, when I had my stroke, you know, I had the, you know, I was able to be resuscitated. I wouldn't call it a permission or sort of realization that you know, I would like to meet people. I have my sister, she had her baby a couple of days ago, I think Saturday. The days all run together, sorry. I'm happy for her, you know. I'm trying to use that, 'cause, you know, I want to see her, and I want her to be able to meet her. Wanted me to meet her uncle, you know. Jackson's. He's no longer an infant, you know, he's a strapping 7-year-old now. And, you know, and now there's Joanna. So, I'm trying to keep using that as inspiration to keep fighting the fight and keep going. Trying to use that as inspiration, keep going, you know, because I don't have any kids of my own. So, I have my brothers, they have their kids, and my sister, she has her kids now, and, you know, it's hard when you realize that there was, you always knew that there was something that was wrong. And, you know, trying to communicate to people. Because, with siblings, they'll always listen to you, but, how it is with families, they have to listen, it's like you don't know that. That you're communicating the wrong thing. Because as a sibling, they put up with you. And we didn't know that I had Asperger's or autism, maybe we'll call it. Trying to meet people, it's hard because you're always second guessing that you're saying the wrong thing, and when you're talking to someone online, you don't get the feedback. You're saying the wrong thing, or I don't know where I'm going. I would like to someday get out there and, see the world, or I live too much right where I'm at, I've always lived within 100-mile radius of Everett, where I grew up, in Everett, Seattle, where my birthplace is, and just the Pacific Northwest of Washington. I would like to get out there and see some more of the world. My older brother, he took his son to Italy last summer, and that would be cool that would be cool to go to Italy and see some Italy, France, and see some art exhibits. There's so much of this world that I've only seen in books, and that's not enough for me anymore. I still have the anxiety, but there's some motivation too.